Hello and welcome to the Longines Global Champions Tour here in Vienna, in this dramatic setting of the Belvedere Park. It has been a part of Austrian history, currently now houses the Austrian Gallery of Art, featuring the likes of Gustav Klimt's The Kiss and many other great names in the art world. But it dates back to 1700 and it's part of the great history of Vienna. And taking it in is American writer Lauren Hough. Great to see you here, Lauren. And I mean, we're looking at an American that we've taken around the world, haven't we? You've been to some amazing places in the last few weeks.
I have, the last few months. This is an incredible tour, and to get to travel to all these amazing places makes me feel very, very fortunate to be able to do a sport in these incredible cities.
And in terms of where you've been, what you've seen, I mean, you've obviously growing up in the United States. I mean, what's it been like taking in old Europe?
To be honest, I was saying to a friend of mine the other day, I think I've probably seen more of Europe than I have of America. But yeah, it's incredible. And I think I try really hard when we're at these venues to have a little bit of time in between to be able to see some of these historic places. And you don't so often get to come. We don't have so much free time, so I try to do it while I can.
Which one's the best on the tourist trail so far this year?
Yeah, this is really stunning. I've been here twice before, and Rome was incredible last week. They all have their special place, but these two, as far as historic, are quite extraordinary.
Well, you've been jetting to many countries this year, including to Canada for the Pan Am Games as well, where you won double bronze. I mean, that was another great one on your CV, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a big accomplishment for me to win an individual medal. It's something I've really been working hard for. I've been to the Pan Am two other times, but to come home with an individual medal was really special and something I'm very proud of.
And going off, I mean, you had a fantastic horse out there, Ooh La La, from that point of view. But the likes of Quick Study, Classico, Windy City horse that you started with. Take us through some of those fantastic horses that have developed your career.
Yeah, Classico took me to the Olympics when I was very young, and he also was young, 9 years old. And then straight away came Windy City, who was an incredible small horse, a little bit like Ooh La La, but did some extraordinary things. Casadora, Quick Study, and now we have my little Ooh La La. So I'm really fortunate to have had many horses that have done many great things for me over a long period of time.
And in terms of looking ahead, I mean, you've got some very good horses coming up in terms of young horses and so forth. But I mean, your style, we always see you, you're pretty quick, you're fast, you're forward going. Where did that all come from?
I don't know. I seem to get along with horses that have a lot of blood. I think I'm a pretty calm rider in general, and so I think that I work well with those types of horses. But I wouldn't say I particularly go out and look for them. I think somehow they find me, and it's worked well, and so far so good.
And in terms of the Longines Global Champions Tour this season, what's it been like for you to compete in all these venues?
Yeah, it's been good. I would say I've been fairly consistent. Not a top three placing, which I'm still looking for, but I believe I'm in the top 10 right now overall going into the end of the season, and I'm very happy. I'm bringing a couple of new ones along, and I would say it's been consistent, but I would still like to be better, of course.
And we've been in some sunny venues as well from that point of view. And, you know, looking ahead, too, in terms of riders, I mean, you've been training Paracelon, who's been competing on a lot of the legs of the tour. How has she found things this year on her first year?
I think it was a super experience for her. As I said during the beginning, it's a little bit like being thrown in the deep end. But I think she learned a lot from it, and I think she'll be better for it next year. She's going to do some shows out in California this fall and concentrate on her studies, and we'll see where we go with it next year. But I think she'll benefit from it in the future for sure.
And in terms of jetting around the world, I mean, you just mentioned there California. I mean, that's just one of your stops, and of course all the stops on the Longines Global Champions Tour. How do you manage all that, keeping up with aeroplanes and just yourself, before we get onto the horses?
I have a really good staff that try to point me in the right directions, but it does take a lot of organizing. I would say, if you ask people around me, I'm a bit of a procrastinator. I try to wait till the last minute, but it really forces you to have to think ahead and plan each horse's schedule accordingly. It takes a bit of logistical nightmare, but we work it out in the end.
And in terms of facilities, I'm going to say facilities for riders. I've been and seen many of the hotels that you stay in throughout. I mean, they're pretty luxurious. It's pretty nice traveling.
Yeah, we're very spoiled and very, very lucky for sure.
And in terms of turning that onto the horses, then, from that point of view, I mean, the horses in terms of travel, welfare, everything that goes into the planning, I mean, that's a big logistical thing, isn't it?
It is. For more than half the year, I'm based in the UK, which I love being there. But it does take, again, a lot of planning and thinking ahead. And I really always try to put the horse first and make sure that if it's a long travel, that there's a couple stops and that we always have two drivers. And we always try to think of health and safety and then the competition.
And even at shows now, I mean, you look, even with the global tour, we have a team of vets that travel. I mean, it's well set up now.
Absolutely. I think all of us together, the horse's welfare is of the utmost importance to everyone.
And what are the long-term aims for you? I mean, you've achieved so much already. I mean, what would you really like to see sitting on the mantelpiece?
Yeah, there's many, many things, but I think I have Rio in the back of my mind if my little mare Ulala is in good form. To win some of these global champions tours. And I think I've always said in the past that it's really important for me to stay consistent at a high level and always try to manage the horses as best I can and pick the right horses, and then I think the results follow after that.
And did you ever think, I mean, you came from a very equestrian background in the first place. Give us a little bit of that. But I mean, that this is the kind of place, sitting here in Vienna, this is the kind of place you'd end up.
No, I never thought I'd end up here. But yes, I grew up with horses in my life. My father, both my parents were professionals. My father rode in the Olympics in 1952 in three-day eventing. And my mother ran a very successful business out in California for many years. So I think I was riding probably before I could walk.
And in terms of, did you ever have any set vision, or was it something that just came to you that was part of your life?
I think I can remember being a small child in school and always, you know, someone says, well, what are you going to do when you grow up? And you always say, I'm going to ride in the Olympics. And I achieved that goal quite young in life, probably not appreciating it as I did it, but reflecting back now, that's always what we say. And now I think what's really important to me is to try to stay at a high level for a long time.
Is there any advice you'd give yourself back in Sydney in 2000 if you were looking at it now?
I think it probably was better that I didn't have any idea what I was getting myself into. I remained very calm, and I produced the best results I could at the time. But obviously now, with a lot more experience under my belt, I think if I have the opportunity to go again, it's, you know, individual and team medals are the most important thing.
And in terms of home nation, I mean, there are lots of Americans traveling on the Longines Global Champions Tour and based in Europe throughout the summer season. It's a little bit of home from home, isn't it?
Yeah, I'd say the world is getting smaller each and every year. In the beginning, when I started coming here, there were only two or three of us that were spending a lot of time here. And now it seems each year there's quite a lot of Americans that come, and I think that's good for our sport. I think it's a global sport and it's getting bigger every year.
And the strength of your teammates, I mean, Kent Farrington, McLean Ward, BZ Madden, we've all seen them on the tour. I mean, America's pretty strong at the moment.
Yeah, I think we have quite a lot of depth in our country, and I think our long-term goals are to produce a team medal in Rio next year.
Well, potential for that. And of course, as you say, top 10 at the moment on the Longines Global Champions Tour, chance to go a little bit further from that one. Of course, looking forward to Vienna here, when we'll see how that goes, but also looking forward to Doha, no doubt.
Yes, I have a newer mount here, Cornette, but he's been progressing really well, and I think he's in very good form, and then I'll bring Ulala to Doha.
Try and finish off there well from that point of view. Is there any other cities around the world we haven't been to yet that you'd quite like to stop off in?
I'm actually getting the opportunity to go to China for the first time this year. I've never been there, and I'm looking forward to doing that. But nothing that I can think of off the top of my head, but I just feel so fortunate to be sitting here at the moment.
Absolutely. Well, we're going to let you do a little bit of the tourist nose around as well, but hopefully maybe join us in Shanghai next season on the Longines Global Champions Tour. But it's been some season, and I know you've enjoyed it.
Thanks very much, Stephen.
Well, thank you to Lauren Hough, who's been already flying high. And, you know, we see where the final finish comes in the overall rankings on this year's Longines Global Champions Tour. But from us here in Vienna, we'll see you very soon.